Why mythology? Have crept into our churches. Why mythology? Has crept into our churches. Is mythology a collection of myth, especially one belonging to peculiar religious or cultures, tradition, tales and stories, folklore, Greek word for myth, the Greek goddess. They have crept in unaware by so many. Number one, they love finances, the promise of paying off things in the organization or the church. That's number one. Why mythology have crept into our churches? Number two, they love the story of fables and myth of their era, like Horace, one well-known pastor in California, has Horace in his glass. Hallelujah, behind him, the seeing eye of all, seeing God, they say, but the Freemason or mythology. My friend, this well-known pastor in California have the Horace on his glass. My friend, what I'm saying, what you saying, preacher? I'm saying the all-seeing eye is not scripture. Horace is not scripture. Horace, hey, glory to God, is mythology. Number three, they like the faces of satanic movement in our corner behind closed door. Yes, they like the faces of satanic movement in our corner behind closed door. I'm talking about 10 F's of why folks love mythology. Hallelujah. Number four, they are moving in fakeness and hoax, calling altar a stage. Hey, glory to God. What? They are moving in fakeness and hoaxness, calling the altar a stage. Number fifth reason, they love being friendship with the world of, hallelujah, occultism. What? They love being in friendship with the world of occultism. In James chapter 4, verse 4, and the Bible says, he adulterer and adulteress, know ye not the friendship of this world is enmity with God. Whosoever thou shall be a friend of the world is of enemy of God. Number six reason, they love the fact of holiness. Hey, glory to God. They don't love the fact of holiness. They don't love the fact of holiness, but become lukewarm Christian in the Hallelujah church. Yes, they don't love faith. Yes, they don't love faith. They love instant microwave blessing. They don't love faith. They love it now. Instant microwave blessing. Claim your wife. And now you get today and end up in divorce next year. My friend, I'm talking about why mythology has crept into our churches. Number eight, they don't like fundamentals. Yes, they don't like fundamental. They love myth. They love folklore. They love tradition. They love story rather than hearing the Holy Spirit speaking to the church. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit say to the church. Number ninth reason, we calling men fathers on earth, especially overseas, calling your pastor papa and your co-pastor mama. Hey, glory to God. You are moving, hallelujah, and are in the mythology ministry. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, we calling men fathers on earth, especially overseas. Hallelujah. Alcohol, my friend, calling your pastor papa and your co-pastor mama. You are moving and are in mythology religion or mythology ministry. Number 10th reason, my friend, they have compared the folklore teaching to Jesus Christ. They have compared the folklore teaching to Jesus Christ. What you talking about, preacher? I'm talking about disciples feeding 5,000, Jesus Christ's death and his resurrection. They are mythology, as is the word describe them, fables, myth, and fake-like. Many of these churches in America and overseas, and they're leading many to a lake of fire. I'm talking about, my friend, mythology have crept into the churches. Anytime you see an eye on a tree, and I'm going to show you a picture, my friend. Anytime you see an eye on a tree, that is Freemasonry. Anytime you see the all-seeing eye on a dollar bill in a pyramid, it is Illuminati. So mythology have crept in to our organization, crept into our churches, and crept into our mind. We think mythology is the same as being a Christian, but the devil is a liar. Mythology has nothing to do with Christian. Mythology has to do with Christianity, but mythology has nothing to do with Christian. What's the difference, preacher, about Christianity and Christian? I'm so glad you asked. Christianity is of the world. Christianity is Mormon. Christianity is Jehovah's Witness. Christianity is Seventh-day Adventist. Christianity is Scientology. Christianity is the World Church, hallelujah, of David Peck, of David P. Peck. Christianity is the Unitarian Church. Christianity is Pentecostal Church. Christianity is the Charisma Church. Hallelujah, like Joe Osteen and T.D. Jakes and Glory to God, Crift Old Dollar, those are Christianity. But to be a Christian, you love the scripture. You tell men the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life to Jesus Christ. Being a Christian, you tell people, for God so loved the world, as Moses lifted the serpent in the wilderness, even so shall the Son of Man be lifted, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Christians say, great love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. If you are a friend of God, you love to keep God's commandment. If you are a friend of God, you're the friendship of the world. The world, glory to God, being saved for Christ and not the world saving, glory to God, the world saving you to be like them. We don't celebrate a worldly throne. Our throne is holy. Holiness without, no man shall see the Lord. And glory to God. And don't forget to subscribe to my video. Until then, my friend, may God get us out of the mythology churches. Hey, glory to God.